What's going on, everybody? My name is Michael, your RV guy here at the Great Outdoors RV in Greeley, Colorado. Today we got a 2024 Rockwood Ultra Lite. We're looking at the 2720IK. So you're gonna be 33 feet, 1 inch tip to tail, and about 8,200 pounds dry. So you're most likely gonna want to be up in a 2500 unless you have a special edition 1500. Looking right off at the front cap here, we have a molded fiberglass front cap, so that's gonna last a lot longer. You got an automotive windshield, so that's gonna be able to take a lot of road debris. Two 30-pound tanks, so you can last a lot longer in the backcountry, having that additional propane. Room for two batteries. You can fit 2 6-volt batteries too if you'd like to go that direction. Convenient spot for your battery disconnect right under the propane tanks there. And then an electric tongue jack to make your life a little bit easier. As you go down the side of the coach here, we got a couple good features. We have electric stabilizers, so that way it's just a touch of a button. Not very hard to do that. You got frameless windows, so you're not gonna have that rubber seal that is susceptible to weather damage and allowing water to go right down your sidewalls. You're not gonna have that. It's all gonna be protected by the tinted window, so that way you're not gonna have to worry about water damage over time. Electric awning, two of them by chance there, with LED light bars going down the sidewall. Room for a 17-inch griddle that Rockwood will provide you for free, and then you also have a little spot for a table there too. And then they even put in, already from the factory, a spot for your TV if you'd like to go that direction. 30-inch entry door, so a little bit wider so you can get furniture in and out. A lot of folks will ask us, you know, right when we're standing by the door here, because they don't see the stickers everywhere, is this a four-season camper? Now, the thing about Rockwood is they've been around for a long time, so they're not the type of company that wants to eat their words. The whole idea with what four-season is it really just depends on where you are. Up here in Colorado, I wouldn't necessarily say any camper's four-season, but Rockwood does do what everybody else does when it comes to the 12-volt heat pads and forced hot air going underneath. The thing that they do different is on the control panel inside, they actually have a button you can push, so you're not worried about sensors going in and out. You can actually push the button and know it's on. When you're looking at their steps in the Rockwood, they are piston assisted, so anybody can do that. They are zero gravity, don't weigh a dang thing, up and down nice and easy. When you're pulling this out, you do have a nice little handle that they provide for you as well, and this is very easy to adjust your steps. You just push this in and it's an in and out. They do provide you with a screen door as well, and it's got a little bungee in it, so when you're not having wind pushing it that way on this little kite here, it actually closes for you, so that's pretty sweet. Grab handle going in as well. Now, as you're going down the side of the coach here, we got two outside speakers, outside kitchen. So we do, remember, we have the 17-inch griddle over there, and then you got this right here. So you pull this bad boy out, pull this bad boy out, and then we got two burner cooktop. Come on now. How smart was that? They didn't take up a ton of space. They didn't need much space for a cutout for this, but they still provided you with a two burner cooktop, table, little beer fridge, and then a 17-inch griddle. So your outside amenities are amazing, this coach. Coming around the back side, you got your back electric stabilizers, spot for your stinky slinky on the bumper guard here. Spare tire, ladder going up to the roof that's fully walkable. Now, on your roof on this coach, we got a 200-watt solar panel as a standard feature, but here at the Great Outdoors, we provide you with one extra. So we have 400 watts of solar, and then this year, Rockwood went from a 1,000-watt inverter to an 1,800-watt inverter. So that's gonna allow you to do a lot more off-grid camping, or I should say, that's gonna allow you to do a lot more when you're off-grid camping. I like how they also changed up the solar controller too. Last year, they were doing a 30-amp solar controller. They went up to a 55-amp solar controller, so that's more capable, basically. Now, prepped for a backup camera back here as well. Now, with this Rockwood, they are prepped for two ACs, so we're gonna have a 50-amp service back here. I believe we have two ACs in hours. We'll check when we get inside. Hot and cold water spout back here so you can spray off your friends if they're misbehaving. And then as you go down the side of the coach here, we do have a couple extra things. 6-gallon hot water heater right there, all your water hookups. This does have a black tank flush. That's super important to note. And I also like how they even gave you this little light here too, so that way you can see what you're doing at night. All your tank releases right underneath here. Good distance off the ground. And this is an important time to mention too, the tires on this coach. Because you can kind of see them right from there. You got your Goodyear tires coming right out of the factory. Come on, everybody knows that when you buy a camper, you're probably gonna switch the tires to some Goodyears. At least you guys got it right from the factory with these guys. They also put on Dexter torsion Torflex axles. So that means your coach is gonna ride like an Airstream or a horse trailer rather than just a regular camper. Now, stuff in this price point is typically going to have leaf spring axles, which is gonna be a a pole, your tires on it, and then your camper welds it to the top. So when you take a nice little, you know, divot turn when you're in the backcountry and the camper starts going like this, well, the whole camper goes with it, which I don't know about you, but when I'm spending this kind of money, I want to make sure that camper's riding smooth. So when you ride with a Rockwood, one tire goes down, the other goes up, your camper rides flat the entire time. So everybody loves that feature about it. And it also comes with a temperature pressure monitoring system, so you can read the temperature and pressure of your tires while you're riding. Looking underneath the bed in this coach, I like how they gave you the outside access, so that way you can put your camp chairs. They gave you the camp carpet in here, so you don't have to worry about what you put in there. But it's a nice spot, and I like that they didn't waste it. This is also an important time to mention too, that Rockwood does it a little different when it comes to their framing. Most coaches in this price point are going to market that they have an aluminum frame coach, right? Well, the difference here is that most of those coaches are going to have a wood truss system. On a Rockwood coach, we have what's called a 6-point aluminum structure. When you're looking under the bed here, you can see some of that aluminum framing under the bed, because what they're going to do is everything in this coach that's structural is going to be framed in aluminum. Now, what that means is basically you got your two sidewalls, right? One and two. We got your front cap and rear cap, and then you got your ceiling, and then your floor. So that's 5 and 6. Unbelievable. So they're putting a ton of extra money into the framing of this coach. That way, when you're looking at it and you're considering a Rockwood as a buy to buy, you know this is going to last you a heck of a lot longer than most of this stuff in this price point. So remember, we are in the 2720IK, so with 33 feet, 1 inch tip to tail, and about 8,200 pounds dry, so you're most likely going to want to be in a 2500 for this coach. Uh-oh, Nick, I can tell these batteries are dying, buddy.
Oh, no.
All right, we got to do this quick, guys. We got the opposing slides back here, so you have an absolute ton of space. A nice little desk back here in the corner. We'll start right off with that, because a lot of folks are considering this for full timing. I like how you got your power bank. Nice amount of a good amount of counter space, little seat cubby right there, and then you got two other cubbies back up here that are all pass through. But you got USB-C, USB, and then two GFCIs, and then when you close this, that's a wireless charger. So tons of space. I like the window back there too. Kitchen island with the farm style sink and the drop down faucet. 12 volt fridge that'll open up from both sides. That's super unique. So that's something new that they did this year, and that's 11 cubic feet. Good amount of pantry space right there. And then this is all real hardwood, all tongue and groove as well, so you know this is gonna last you a heck of a lot longer than most stuff. And they do not glue in the middle piece, so that way you can go up and down in elevation without worrying about your wood getting bigger and going smaller. What am I trying to say?
Expand and contract.
Yes, yeah. Look at that, dude. Bill Nye the Science Guy, what we do without him. More pass through up here, so that way you can put your dishes and stuff away. Good spot for your kitchen knives right there. That way you don't have to worry about those moving around in transit. Cast iron cooktop with the 3-burner cook. Or cook, the cook, dude, you know what I'm saying?
Oh yeah.
The stove. I'm getting tired already.
I know.
Plenty of counter space, I really like that. They gave you the sink covers. And then show this off, Nick, too. You got even more storage in the kitchen island. And this is a good spot to show off the tongue and groove when it comes to the cabinetry. Check this out. So when you're looking at cabinetry, you know that's a little bit better than what you're typically seeing, which is going to be a flat line, and you know that means they stapled or glued it. I like the tongue and groove. That's going to be way more residential. This is your entertainment section, so you got the 4,500-watt electric fireplace, so that's going to put off about 10 to 15 degrees of heat. And then check this out. We got our televator. We'll have Nick fast-forward this. I can't wait to see that and fast forward.
Oh, yeah.
So there you go. You got your TV right there on the televator. Blocks off the window, so you can actually close this off here too. And that way it's going to feel like that window's not even there when you're watching TV. Behind the TV, we got your theater seating with the wireless charging and their new couches. They did a good job with these couches this year. They're a little bit different than what I've seen in the past. These are a Millersburg collection, so coming right out of the place that they build these Rockwoods themselves. But I really like this. This is super comfortable. Faces the TV, so you don't have to break your neck while you're watching your movie. But overall, it looks really nice. And I like when you sit down here too, you can notice the underlit countertops. That looks really fancy from here. But this is definitely a crowd favorite. I've sold a lot of these coaches to folks that are traveling the country, and they're going to be spending a lot of time in this thing. But when you have opposing slides in your living space here, unbelievable. It gives you a ton more space than what you're used to in a typical camper, is what I should say. And then I didn't really mention back here too, you do have a foldable dinette, so that way you're gonna have plenty of space to play cards and stuff. That table will go outside with you if you wanted to bring it out there. But when you fold that down, that'll provide you an extra sleeping spot too. So if your friends visit you on the road, it's a good spot for them. Your control panel on this will allow you to control all your lights here. You got your tank heater button, like I mentioned, outside. This camper can be connected to your phone too, where you can control your awnings, lights, and slides. I really like that feature because if you park this camper in a campground with not a lot of space in that campsite, you can actually go outside and stand right next to your slide and open it right from your phone so you don't have to worry about hitting a tree or something. As you go into your bathroom here, we got Jack and Jill entrances so you can get in from your bedroom if you wanted to. Tons of linen space in this coach, letting it kind of sneak around there. But tons of space, so you don't have to worry about how much room you got for your towels and stuff. Honestly, when you're looking around at this coach, the only way you're not going to be able to fit everything is if you forget it at home. Come on now. You like that one, dude?
It's a good one.
It's a good one.
That's great.
I like that one a lot. Porcelain toilet, good size sink here, medicine cabinet, kid. And then what we got for our shower? Let's see here. Oh, whoa. You can see through this skylight, dude. I'm going to be blinded. I can see the clouds. I think people are gonna like that. That's pretty fancy. And I got a lot of space here too. Good radius shower. And then they got what's called the shower miser. So when you're looking in that shower there, you have this little lever. You see how it's off, on. The whole idea here is that you only got a 6 gallon hot water heater. Most people when they're on the road are worried about, can I take a normal shower or am I gonna be taking a military shower? The whole idea with a Rockwood with the shower miser system, and honestly they're putting this in a lot of Rockwood, Forest River products. So I'm really liking what they're doing, but the whole idea is that blue rubber seal right there that you can see inside the shower. When that is blue, it's not ready. What you do is you turn your hot water on, flip this lever down, and then when that turns red, your water's ready. What's happening there is the water, instead of coming out of the faucet and wasting 2 gallons or so, is going back in the hot water heater and raising to a temperature of 92 degrees. Once it's at that temperature, that blue seal will turn red. Like I said, that's when you'll know it's ready. But rather than wasting 2 to 3 gallons, it's nice that it just goes right back in the hot water heater. You got a full 6 gallons. Max air fan is a standard feature with a cover, so you don't have to worry about if it's raining outside or not. Pocket doors in this coach so you don't have to worry about getting in the way. Tons of space in your king bedroom. So you got a king bed. The bed does lift up, and this is another good opportunity. Oh, where's my handle here, bro? Another good opportunity to mention the aluminum framing. I always tell people when you're looking at stuff in the same price point, one big test to see how good this thing is when it comes to the quality, stand on the bed right in the corner there. If that can hold you up, I don't know, that's pretty dang good. I would love to, you know, see how those one by ones hold up when you try that. And then you try to tell me when it comes to this price point, where are we gonna be better off when it comes to spending our money and our time. Second AC in this bedroom here, so that 50 amp service was prepped for that second AC. Like I said, we did end up adding ours in. Tons of storage space back here. All under the bed, you got the two drawers, you got cabinets all over here. Front cap window. Does close off as well. Plenty of plugs, USBs. I can see USB-Cs everywhere. There's a ton of stuff. This is a beautiful use of space. Your outlets next to the bed here are gonna be both inverted, so that those are gonna be the outlets that you're gonna be able to use when you are off-grid camping. Now, again, we are in the Rockwood Ultra Lite 2720IK. 33 feet, 1 inch tip to tail, and 8,200 pounds dry. So like I said before, you'll probably wanna be in a 2,500. My name is Michael here at The Great Outdoors RV. Give us a call at 970-313-4337, and we will catch you guys next time.